much about statistics, and we're still doing it. So now we talk about Modi. Modi, of a set of data, the value with the highest frequency. That's what I can see. In the data, the value is the highest frequency, we call it Modi. Now, out of all data that you've been given, either in the question or in anything or in the table, if you find a data with the highest frequency out of all, that is called Modi. Now, Modi is the data with the value with the highest what? Frequency. Example, if now you've been given this list of numbers, the model of the set of the numbers, now you have 1, 0, 2, 4, 2, 3, 5, 3, 6, 0, 3, 4. The mod is 3. Why is it 3? Because it appears several times than the other. That is, you find it easy. 3 is here, 1, 2, 3. But others means it's because 3 occurs the most number of times. It occurs the most number of times. Now, if it would happen that I should write the frequency of these numbers, I would have written 3 with the highest frequency. And that is called mod. Mod in a frequency, kubwa. Kwa data ambayo ina frequency kubwa, ndo tunaita nini? We call it mod. And therefore, in a data with the frequency distribution, mod is the value with the highest frequency. Now, when you're talking about a mod, it is something you have to understand. It is the value with the highest frequency. That is all. Now, determine the value with the highest frequency, you have to know. Now, we're talking about what? Mod. And it is abbreviated by this symbol. This is mod. Example, the table below shows marks of obtained. Marks obtained by 20 students in a test. In a test, these are the marks. 60 were 2 students who got what? 60. 63 were 5 students. 68 were 8 students. 73 students. Now 75 were 2 students. Now find the mod. Now it is only going to the marks which have got the highest frequency among of them. That is the mod. Now from here, the mod is 68. Why? Because it has the highest frequency of 8. Because 6 is by 2. 63 is by 5. 68 is by 8. 70 is by what? By what? 3. And 75 is by 2. Now the value that have the highest frequency, that is called mod. And now this is the frequency, how we can determine the mod. Mod of the grouped frequency distribution. And the group we have discussed, you only look at the mark or at the value with the highest frequency. But how about group D, frequency distribution? In a group D, frequency distribution, lies. The mod lies in the class referred to as model class. We have something called what? Model class. It is something called model class. The model class is the interval that has the highest frequency. The interval that has got the highest frequency. The model of the such group data can be obtained by using the formula. This is the formula that can be used to determine the mod of the grouped data. Mod is equal to L plus T1 over T1 plus what? T2. Bracket times I. What is L? What is T1? What is T2? What is I? L is the lower class boundary of the model class. Imagine now we have an example. Let us refer to an example here, so as we can understand. If you look this example, this is the table below shows the age of students who attended an HIV AIDS awareness camp. This is the table. Age 14 to 15 were 10 of them, and 16 to 17 were 35. Age 18 to 19 were 50 of them. And then 20 to 21 were 24 students. And 22 to 23 were 16 students. Now, out of this table, you look at the class map, you look at the class inter, the class mode, the mode of class, which have got highest quality frequency. The mode of class that have got the highest frequency is this one. Because 18 up to 19, we have 50 students who attended for the HIV/AIDS awareness camp. Now we say that is a model, we call it model class. A model class is 18 to what? To 19. Now we have upper class and we have lower class. We have upper bound, we have lower boundary. We have lower boundary and upper boundary. Now if this is the lower class boundary and this is the upper class boundary, now we have 17.5 to 19.4.5. Are you together?
Yes.
We have 17.5 to 19.5. Now, our intention in this is not this one. That is not our tension. Our tension is the lower class. In the lower class, that is what we are saying, the lower class boundary. Now, that is L. Now, L is equal to 17.5. That is the lower class. And then, T1 is the excess of the mode frequency over the next lower class. Over the next lower class, T1, you take this one to the left. And T2 is taking this one to the right. Are we together?
Yes.
Taken from the highest frequency to the left. And this one is taken from the highest frequency to the right. And therefore, T1, what means? It is 50 minus 35, which now is equal to what? 15. And T2 is equal to 50 minus 24. Now, which is equal to 24? 26. Now, you have this one, and then you have this one. So, if that is the case, now, we are talking about N, and we are talking about T1. We are talking about what? T2. Now we are looking for the, what we call it, the model class interval. The model class interval is obtained by taking the upper class boundary minus the lower class boundary. Now, class interval, that is this one, I, is equal to 19.5 minus 17.5. Now, which is equal to what? To 2. Now, from here, now I have everything. Now, the mod, now I say mod is equal to L plus, now it is T1 over T1 plus T2. Then, times what? I. Remember now, L is equal to 17.5 plus T1. T1 is 15. Then, over T1, which is equal to 15 plus 26. Then, times 2. Are you together? Now, this is a mathematical concept in which now you will get the frequency equal now to 17.5, then plus 0.3659, then multiplied by 2. Means I've taken 15 over 41. Now, which now is equal to 17.5 plus, it is plus 0.73. Now, modi is equal now to this one plus this one, which now is equal to 18.23. This is how we determine mod. So the most important case here is how to determine this L from what? From here. But only you choose here, we call it a classy, it is called model class. A model class is taken where the frequency, there is a highest what? Frequency. From there, it is now you can obtain the T1 and T2. T1 to the left and T2 to the right. Means this one minus this one, this minus this one. After there, you only substitute what is required to be done. And that's why the mod is defined by this one. When the histogram has equal class intervals, why is it equal? Means the class interval from this point A to B, the same as the class interval from B to C, and the same as the class interval from C to D. That's what we mean here. When a histogram has equal class interval, the model class, the interval is the tallest bar. The one with the tallest bar is chosen to be model class. It's taken to be a model what? A model class. Among you, we have three bars here. Among of them, this is the tallest one. Now this one, the tallest one, is taken to be a model class. So we have two things. We have two alternatives on how to determine this one. Whether by drawing or by calculation, just using the formula. By drawing, you draw a line. If now this is a model class, it is a histogram, and this is a model class. Now, the distance from here up to here is taken as T1. And this here up to here is taken as T2. Now this is T1, this is T2. Are we together? Then you draw a line. This is by drawing. You draw a line from here going this way, right here. Then a line right here, a straight line. Are we together? Now you have drawn this line to this side, whether it is the upper one or it is the lower one, I don't care. But next to the right and next to the left. Then the place where this line that you have drawn, they have met, the place where they have already met. You draw a straight line following the class map. A dotted line following the body, the class map, dotted line. Then the number that you meet here, it is what we call it mode. So that is the graphical method. So you can use the graphical method to determine the mode of the group histogram. But according to the formula, find the model class and the mode in the histogram below. According to calculation made graphically, I would have drawn this way, here to this corner, and this one to this corner. Then I would have drawn dotted line moving to the horizontal line, to the class marks, class marks, class marks. Then here, if I would have used the glass, it is where automatic I would have got what we call it mode. It is only leading. Only by using the graphical method, you can determine mode. Just see from the point of intersection of the line that you have drawn, then up to this point. Now this is called mode. Now if now I would have used the glass, now it is between 20 and 40 and 30. Maybe 21, 22, 23, 24, whatever the case it is. But if I would have used a glass, I would have got the exact number. That modi is equal to this one. So this is the way we do. But using the formula, you just choose the tallest bar at the model, at the model class. After you have taken the tallest bar at the model class, then the model class is 20 to what? To 30. After you've been given the diagram, don't consider for the something called plus or minus, absolute here that we definitely use here. You only take the number. Do you understand? Now this is the lower class boundary. That is L. Is equal to what? 20. Now the class interval is this minus this one, which is equal to what? Now it's equal to what? 10. Now we have L and we have I. Now we are looking for T1. And then we are looking for T2. T1 to the right, to the left. T2 to the right. Now T1 The frequency. Now the frequency of this one is 10. Now to the left, here it is. Now it is 10 minus the frequency of the of this bar. Now that is 10 minus 6. Then this one to T2 to the right. Now the highest frequency is 10. Then we're talking about here. It is here, this man at this one. Then this man at this one. Now it is 10 minus 8. Now it's equal to 10 minus what? 8. Now mod is equal to L, then T1 over T1 plus T2. Times what? Times the I. It is 10 to 8. 10 minus what? 8. Now 10 minus 6 is what? 4. 10 minus 8, it is what? 2. Now, if that is the principle, now L is 20. Then plus T1, 4. Over 2 plus 4. Times what? 10. Then you have 20 plus. This is 4 over 6 times 10. Now, we have 20 plus, then 4 over 6 times what? 10. Mathematically, now we have 20, then 4 over 6. Now, which is equal now to 20 plus? That is 6.7, which now is equal to 26.7 kilogram. Now, the mod is equal to 26.7 what? Kilogram. This is how we determine. Now you can choose whether to use a graphical method, if now somebody has told you to do so, or to use the other, to use what? Formula. So it is something very important and you need to understand. That is the end of the module.